Right, the first race on day two in National Hunt is a 2.6 novice hurdle from Leopardstown. Some big races at Leopardstown this week. Russell Crowe, Patrick Hogan, number one. Two Carson's Rocket for Paul Rhodes. Commemoration Puzzle, Stu Gray. Pan Muir for Davey Robertson. Roundabout, Alex Cherry. Zephonic Gent, Graham Clutterbuck. Pendula Pitstop, Martin Liederman for more for Alex Cherry. There's eight horses in this race at Leopardstown. A novice hurdle, and away they go, and it's the grey horse Carson Rocket who jumps off in front from Pam Mew on his outside. Then comes the orange cap and orange tees of roundabout for Alex Cherry. The red colours on that one's inside is Pendula Pitstop for Martin Liederman. They're followed by Patrick Hogan's Russell Crowe. It's just on the outside of Symphonic Gent for Mo, the grey horse. The second grey in the field's on the outside of that, in the back of the field, Commemoration Puzzles. Only four lengths off this leader, who now is Pam Mew, and it's Pam Mew who's pulling hard in front from a second Carson's Rocket for Paul Rhodes. Then comes Pendula Pitstop is on the outside, followed by the second of the greys in the race for Alex Cherry. Russell Crowe in between horses in the yellow colours and the black cap. On the rail we have roundabout for Alex Cherry. There's only four lengths first to last here. A mistake there by Vermont as he drops to the back of the field off that slow jump. But it's Pam Muir who leads for Davey Robertson from on his inside Carson's Rocket. Then comes roundabout for Alex Cherry, who's on the inside of Pendula Pitstop in those red colours. On the rail, the white, red and green Welsh flag colours of Graham Clutterbuck's Symphonic Gent. Just on the outside, the yellow colours of black cap of Russell Crowe for Patrick Hogan. Out wide, the back colours of Commemoration Puzzle for Stu Gray. In the back of the field, second of the greys, Vermont for Alex Cherry. But Carson's Rocket has won the battle for the lead, and leads from Pam Muir in second for Davey Robertson. Then three lengths back to Symphonic Gent, who's on the inside of Roundabout. Pendula Pitstop is on the outside of these. Then comes a Commemoration Puzzle, is four wide for Stu Gray. The grey horse on that one's inside is Vermont for Alex Cherry. Then Russell Crowe is dropped to the back of the field for Patrick Hogan. But it's the first of the greys, Carson Rocket, who leads the field. There's been joined now by Pam Muir on his outside, and these two dueling for the lead as they pass the stands for the first time. Head off on their final circuit with Carson's Rocket as they're coming past the stands now. Leads from Pam Muir in second for Davey Robertson. The jumper will be the last next time round. Carson's Rocket from Pam Muir in second. Three lengths back, or four lengths back, to Symphonic Gent, who's on the inside of Pendula Pitstop. In between horses is a roundabout. Then Commemoration Puzzle, who's on the outside of the second of the Alex Cherry horses, Vermont, and Russell Crowe at the back of the fields. They pass the stands here at Leopardstown and pass the winning post for the penultimate time. Heading off on their final circuit with Pam Muir, the leader, from Carson's Rocket in second. Then comes Symphonic Gent for Graham Clutterbuck back in third. The red colours of Martin Liederman's Pendula Pitstop is on the outside of the two Alex Cherry horses, Roundabout and Vermont. Commemoration Puzzle is four wide for Stu Gray, and the back of the field, Russell Crowe for Patrick Hogan. So Carson's Rocket for Paul Rhodes leads from the Scottish challenger. Pam Muir reached for that, made a mistake, and has allowed Pendula Pitstop to pass him, as well as the Symphonic Gent on his inside. Then comes the two Alex Cherry horses, Roundabout and Vermont, with Commemoration Puzzle on the outside, and now Russell Crowe has been switched wide to try and improve positions. But Carson's Rocket has gone about 5-6 lengths clear here of Pendula Pitstop in second. Pam Muir, after that slow jump, is trying to improve again back in third. Then Symphonic Gent for Graham Clutterbuck, followed by Alex Cherry's Roundabout and Vermont. Commemoration Puzzle behind that, and Russell Crowe has never really gotten it yet, with 8 furlongs left to travel. A mile left to go. Carson's Rocket from Pam Muir is trying to improve again after that mistake. Then comes Pendula Pitstop. They're starting to get very stretched out here. Roundabout has moved up into fourth. Then the Symphonic Gent and that one inside. From Mob behind that, the Grey Horse, and both Commemoration Puzzle and Russell Crowe are getting detached with 6 furlongs left to go. And as Carson's Rocket from Pam Muir is given time to improve after that slow jump, has moved back onto the quarters of Carson's Rocket. So it's Carson's Rocket, but here comes Pam Muir, who's made that slow jump at mistake and then dropped back, but has now come back to the front. And it's Pam Muir on the outside of Carson's Rocket. Pam Muir from Carson's Rocket. Then comes Pendula Pitstop and Roundabout, and not many have got into this at all. And the two that have been in front most of the way, Pam Muir and Carson's Rocket, they turn for home. We've got a useful advantage of a Pendula Pitstop in third, then Roundabout. The rest aren't even in the picture at this stage, and it's Carson's Rocket The grey horse on the inside who's getting the upper hand, yeah, from Panmure as they turn for home, yeah, at Leopardstown. It's Carson's Rocket from Panmure in second. Carson Rocket and Panmure, they just jump it well. Then Penelope sets up his long bay back in third, and you need some binoculars to see the rest of the field. So it's Carson Rocket in front from Panmure in second. Carson's Rocket, the grey horse for Paul Rhodes, is about a length clear of Panmure in second. Penelope pit stop, he's trying to run on and back in third. He's closing, but has got a lot of ground to make up on this leader, Carson's Rocket. There's Carson's Rocket with a furlong and a half to travel from Panmure in second. Carson's Rocket, Panmure, then Penelope puts up. Carson Rocket jumps it slowly, and Panmure comes to the front for Davey Robertson. Panmure with half a furlong left to go, running on strongly now. Penelope pit stop, but Panmure has an advantage from Carson's Rocket. Penelope pit stop is finishing strongly, also running on his roundabout. It's caught Panmure. Penelope pit stop is trying to get up in the line. Penelope pit stop gets up on the line to beat Panmure. Well, at least I think he did. Martin Leiter was Penelope pit stop. Catches Panmure on the line, I think. Yeah, Penelope pit stop wins from Panmure in second. Roundabout run on strongly for third for Alex Cherry. There's a dead heat for first, actually. It's a dead heat. Penelope pit stop and Panmure dead heat for first. Martin Leiter and Davey Robertson share that. Alex Cherry is back in third with a roundabout. Carson's Rocket back in fourth for Paul Rose. Not many got into that at all. The winner and the second were up in the vanguard most of the way. Martin Leiter wins another one with Penelope pit stop.